Hello and welcome. This is Classic Gamer and this is my next Let's Play. Besides Trackmania Nations Forever, I will play along this game. So, in short, this is a great game. I like very much. I only completed fully once on normal difficulty, so this time I'm gonna try with veteran, so maybe it will be harder, probably will be harder, I'm sure. I will die more, which is good for you. You're enjoying why I fail. So let's start the new game. And here we are, the character creation screen. We have four class: Ember Mage, Berserker, Engineer and Outlander. You can choose the genre to be a male or a female. You choose the male, and we're going to choose the Ember Mage because that's my favorite and I'm more familiar with it, and it's easier to explain through this class. In later on, I will probably show off the other classes, but I probably won't play to or the campaign like I will with this. I will complete with Ember Mage. So let's make our character look. Let's change it. There are five face types: this one, this one, this one, this one, and this one. I kinda like it's so funny how the eyes. I think this one cool too. I think I'll stick with this face. And there are the hair types. This is the bold. This fitting the mage also, but I like the bold one because why not? And the hair color, of course. I think I put this temporarily to show the hair color. There is a brown one, blue one, white one, red one, a light blue, I think. Yes. And white. Oh. Then this one was great, sorry, but no matter what hair color you choose, the bold one is always the same and fine. Okay, our character name will be obviously Classic Gamer if I spell it right. So Here it is. And now we can choose pet. There are 6, 12, 14 types. So this will be fun. There is a little papillon. It's very cute. Or also has 2 appearance. A darker one, a black and a brown. There is a ferret. It's also cute. Half head crab. I think I will choose this because, but I'm gonna show you the other ones. Alpaca, panther. This is also a great one. Also 3 different colors, as you can see. Little purple, purplish, blackish, and whitish. Okay. There is a cat, bulldog, chuckery, also a cute one, a very funny one. It's also a good, I might consider. And stag, there is only one, because this one added in the later version. Wolf. There are also 3 color. Panda. Owl. Badger. But we are going to choose the hawk and the blue one because it is the fits our hero here. Not gonna call Yeti, we're gonna call Hunter. Hunter the pet. So we choose the pet, we choose the hero class, and now we choose the veteran. As we talked about earlier, I'm gonna choose the veteran and maybe some later characters, some elite. Okay. So let's start the intro movie.
Deep beneath torchlight, a darkness gathered. 3 heroes confronted the beast called Ordrak. Yet even in death, Ordrak's corrupted heart endured and called out.
And he's dead.
may fall, hope may fade, but new heroes will arise.
È trascato l'intro? I'm gonna say I like it very much, so here we are, our first not dungeon, an open area, Echo Pass. It's named, and here we are, the first quest. Let's head on.
This is as far as I can go. You should carry on to the Asterion Enclave, but you're on your own. Warn them that the Alchemist destroyed Torchlight and is headed their way. He may be there already.
It's interesting that they added the voice acting, but the actual character didn't speak. It's a little weird, but over. And if you talk again, he says different things.
The Alchemist will be headed this way. And if he passes through here, we'll be waiting for him. Someone needs to warn the Asterians. Head up the pass to their enclave. Find my old friend Commander Vale and let her know what happened.
Yes, I'm not gonna spoil much, but Destroyer. This is the one of the class in the first Torchlight. Warrior type class. I will play those two, but I thought it might be a good idea to play this one. Because I like it more, but I'm sure I will play that one too. So if you talk some of the guards, they say it just some little voice acting. And say some interesting things, like this one. The past infested with wetlands. These are our enemies around here, the most common one in this map. Or this our first open terrain. And there is some stubborn riders too. And there is the stronger ones. They pretty much control the pass right now. We can't get any tips through. Every time we try, we end up with more wonder. That's not good. Let's fix it. Let's see if Toka host. Yeah. You found that the host speed can inspire to quicken your own step. Then it is Toka again. You think the horse winked at you. Maybe not, though. You throw out a few jokes, but the horse seems nonplussed. Gazing into the horse's eyes, you feel on the verge of understanding the deep mystery. I think the horse ignores you. The horse's eyes narrow. You feel a moment of terror. Okay, maybe say anything. I think this horse seems sad like the muddy burdens. This horse clearly thinks he's the main attraction. Okay. I want to show this because it's funny how I think there is a dialogue when he threatens us. But I didn't manage to do that, so that's it. So let's go back a bit, explain some things before we go onward. This is the main spell we use for now. These are the spells. There is a lot of spells. The first one, Magma Spear, is a very decent one, and I like the spells in this game because it scales up with your level, so it never get weak. Just some of them are better, but if you like a spell and upgrading up, you can upgrade it up to tier 3, and each tier has 5 upgrades, so 15 in total. So it's very nice. This is the pet banner. You can also add some gear. It's pretty decent, but it's not extraordinary. This is my character panel where I can add some stats later on. We go. This is the Arcane statistics. You can see some information about your weapon or other stuff. And as I showed it already, this is the hero. This is the consumer. It's a great upgrade from the first game, where the consumer consumes inventory with among the weapons and gear. And there is some space later. So let's start. We have currently only a staff, but we will be getting some others too. So and we have let's arrange this there. Let's put something somewhere else, because I want to put spells here so I can quickly do it. So let's explore this optional area, of course, because this is the main way, but going for loot, so we gonna fix this also. As you can see, this is my experience bar. This is the light blue. When it reaches to here, I will level up. You will see. And this is the charge bar. Each class have different charge bars. For example, the Ember Mage charge bar is an also unique one. When it's charged up, the spells cost no mana and you can do additional 25% damage. It's quite nice, and I will show when I level up the spell I use mostly when I charge up. Also, I forgot to mention that what weapons we could use. I can't use stuff, but also we got a new stuff. I think it's better. Yes, let's change it. There's also a socket, which means we put some gems in it, and there is a function that auto equip the character with the gear, so it's also a nice feature. Let's see if we miss something. Let's destroy this. Okay, we explore pretty much. Okay, and this was only the optional area. Make sure to check everything, because as you can see, we got a hurt and a manipulation. Let's explore further. Yay, we level up. Okay, just a moment. Okay, we put straight to the focus, which is increases our magic damage. There are also dexterity, which adds some critical chance and dodge chance and fumble recovery. I think it's a chance that the enemy can do critical hits, I think, but I'm not sure. Feel free to correct me. Strength, weapon damage and critical damage. Since I'm using a staff, which is a melee, and melee version, and also, but I'm not going to adjust stats from the to the strength, because the mage is mainly do magic damage and it's not efficient. Vitality might do later on. So let's get our new skill. This is my favorite spell besides Magma spell. I will use it a lot. Let's show you. It's a good spell, but very mana hungry, so make sure you charge up this bar before using this, and you can get quite a powerful punch. So we didn't miss any, I hope, at least. Okay. This is a short map. If you're wondering, there will be a lot of maps with large areas, and it will take time to explore. But for this one, I think we are going just fine. Okay. Oh, a staff. Good job, pet. Oh, let's say hunter. Sorry. I don't mean to insult you. Sometimes they throw bones. Interesting. Let's check our new stuff. It's the same, just only without the socket. And we got a pocket pistol, which is the Outlander main weapon. Shield, I think it's main for the engineer, because they have some skills that involves. But you can use in any character if you wish. For example, for mage, if you use one wand, a strong one, and the shield, it perfectly works for you. But I think I'm not going to use, because I probably use two wands or a very strong. Very strong stuff. And nothing here. Set some masters, which give us a lot of experience, so that's good. What I really like about the magma spear that it pierces through the enemies, so it not only hits one enemy like this one, but this also hits multiply enemies because it shoots 5 prismatic bolts, but this hits through the enemies and also give them effects. Fire damage, which is very nice. Okay. What's your problem there? Wow, there is also enemies here. And this third round gives me a hard time to kill any enemies. And also how did I miss it? I don't know, but he is dead now. At least. Let's add the points. I'm going mainly for chart mastery. Maybe this is passive, so it's always enabled. It increases the charge rate and decreases the decay time, so it stays longer and you can obtain it the charge much sooner, which is nice. We always could use some of the free mana, and we had this guy, so he offers some gear. You saved my life. I thought those red things had my number for sure. Oh, we thank you. Now, this is the difficult choice because I think for the first we got also one, but this is not really a good one, so. And this also a decent one, but I'm going to choose this and equip to my pet. Also, if you press the shift and click on it, it's auto equip to your pet, so you don't have to bring there and right click there. Because basically the right click is where you can keep the normal way. So we explore that way, so we're going forward. You can put your pet in aggressive mode, but I don't really suggest because the enemy will wound pretty fast and they will be nearly useless. Of course, there will be some areas where Maybe be useless, but we will see. Oh, this is a boss mini boss. I think it holds a key. Yes, and some nice things. Let's open this chest. Let's find. Oh, lots of gold. I like it. Some ember. Yes, you can equip with the weapon. You gain additional damage, but for now I'm not gonna do it because I'm gonna change the stat soon, and for now I won't have any blacksmith around here to get it back. So I'm not gonna do it. I'm gonna change this. I didn't really get too much good stuff as I expected, but it's okay. Yay, I need some basket. Of course. Let's choose a different map. Yes, we're going this way. Okay. Near the end, so they're calling for help, but it's useless because he was the only one. So rapidly, okay. Good work, Hunter. I know I can trust him. He got my back. So it's a nice thing. And we have completed this area, I think. Yes, I didn't miss anything. So it's good. So I think I will end the episode here because all the explaining stuff and anything it's enough. Thanks so much for watching, and next time we're going to Enclave, our first town. We bring the quest and let's see what's going on. It's definitely this alchemist has some plan to rule the world, and we will see how could we stop. So thanks so much for watching. If you enjoy, give a like button, and we will see in the next episode.